I got a new thing going, and what it's going to be is I am the most judgmental person I know, and I've always tried to fight that. Well, for a month, I'm going to embrace it, and I've got a test, and I'm putting all the names, like I'm trying to try and gather all the names of people I know that I even have semi-contact with, to people that I'm in contact with all the time. It'll be my workers, my co-workers, classes. I'd love to get a list of former classes, people I see in the community, people that I see every so often. And I'm going to go and I'm going to put them in case studies of the target test. And that is, if I see them on the other side of target, do I run to talk to them? Do I hope that I bump into them? Do I say hello if I meet them in an aisle? Do I kind of, you know, hedgingly say hello? Or do I actually hide behind the sunglasses rack and wait till they go away and hope that I don't? And what is it that makes me feel those five reactions? Kind of breaking that down. And I think that even as I go through the first few case studies, I love humility and I love a sense of self-deprecating humor. I really like that. I really am not into self-righteousness. That is one where, and you can get that so quickly, where someone says, I've got a friend who I would run across the store for, and they start everything. If they're going to make a point, they say, I'm probably wrong, but I think. I love it. I'm probably wrong, but here's where I'm coming from right now, because they're even admitting how many false things there are in the world, and whatever I'm going to say, probably someone could jump in and prove it wrong. So there are certain things that I just really love, and it's going to be fun. Okay, so like I'll give you an example. This is case study number one for my target test. This is a high school kid, and I think for kids in general, they're not very good at asking you about your life. Kids wait for you, hey, what are you doing right now? What's your interest? How are you doing? And then they get done telling you, and they don't ask, they don't reciprocate, they don't, hey, I heard that you were involved in this, or I saw on Facebook that you were, how was that? This kid actually does, consistently, comes back with, hey, I heard that you did this, how was that, what was that like? They're inquisitive about you. And right away, as a kid being able to do that, hey, kids out there, you might want to learn that skill, you might want to get that one down, where when someone asks you about you, you actually reciprocate and say, oh, hey, I heard that you were involved in this, or how is it going, or even how are your kids, or how is this guy, I know that you're involved in these kinds of things, where most kids, elementary, middle, high school, college, will just be like, oh, you're asking me what my dreams and future plans are, I'll gladly tell you, but quite frankly, and adults too, I've got family, I mean like close family, that would be their last idea, would be, I could ask them, hey, how'd that go, you were in this, you were involved in that, how's work going? They'll tell you the whole story. And there's no reciprocation. And I mean, I've done some things, even the last couple months, that are kind of out there, zany, and they know that I've done, there's no interest. They've been real adventures. No. You really think I'm going to concern myself? So it's that one thing that I embrace, one thing that really is meaningful to me, is like this high school kid that I'm thinking of that just says, hey, I heard this about you too. What was that like? Most people don't even have that basic skill. It's kind of like, well, the last thing I want to hear about is your adventure. You know, I'm going to tell you how work is or whatever, but you think I'm interested in you? No, it actually does help in the target test to show some reciprocating interest.